Hola! We're back from our trip to Cancun. We had an amazing time. It was our third time there. In fact, we love Cancun so much we're going back in January. But along the way, we've gotten some amazing tips I'm going to share with you that's going to help with your vacation to Cancun. All right, so tip number one is do your research before you go. Not just TripAdvisor, not just looking up the reviews, but actually go to YouTube. Search the resort, and you're gonna see real life, real time videos of that resort. And you can even research the beach, the pool, the food, different things about it. And you're gonna see it for real, not just the version of the resort on their website. Tip number two, going to the Cancun airport. Okay, so the first thing is when you're on the airplane, they're going to be handing out these papers for customs and immigration. Fill them out on the plane. What we did is we did it digitally, online or on the phone, I can't remember. But then when we got there, we ended up having to go back in the line and fill out the papers anyway. So fill out those papers on the airplane. When you get to the airport, don't get caught in the trap of all the people that are gonna hound you when you go through. Just put your head down, say no gracias, no gracias, no gracias, and get through the exit. They want you to book excursions and dinners and trips and all those types of things. You can do that when you get to the airport. I mean, when you get to the resort. But don't do it at the airport. We're gonna talk about transportation in a different tip. But the other thing is when you get to the exit, you're gonna see this beautiful big Margaritaville building. And you're gonna get lured in because you get to Mexico, you want a margarita, right? Well, I've been there three times and I still got caught in the trap. I went to the Margaritaville and I asked for a margarita and didn't ask how much it was, and it was $22 a margarita. $22. It was a good margarita, but not worth $22. So don't get caught in the trap of going to Margaritaville right when you
All
land
right,
at the
tip
airport.
number three is all about money and exchanging the money before you get there. You don't have to do that because they accept almost everything, especially the US dollar and the Canadian dollar, everywhere that you go. And that way you don't have to spend money on the exchange rate and all of those things. The only thing is, we do recommend that you know what the exchange rate is. So if you are purchasing something, you know that you're not being taken advantage of. The other thing too is bring a lot of singles to tip with because they love the US dollar, the Canadian dollar, and you're gonna get amazing service from it. And they don't need to be tipped $5 or $10. $1 is plenty, $2, and they are going to love it. Now, the final thing about money is do not use your debit card when you're going because, God forbid, if it's compromised in any way, that is your bank account, you know, which has all your money in it. So travel with credit cards. Make sure you tell your bank or your credit card company ahead of time that you're going to Cancun so that they know. But do not use your debit card when traveling. All right, tip number four is transportation. I know we talked a little bit about the Cancun airport earlier, but I want to get more into it because you do not want to arrive in Cancun without pre-arranging your transportation, because what's gonna happen is when you get there, you are inundated, like I said earlier, with people trying to get your business. And it's very easy to be taken advantage of. So make sure you arrange it ahead of time. A couple ways you can do it. One is contact the resort. Sometimes, though, they do charge a lot more if it's not free, or with the resort. So just make sure you're getting a fair cost. I would say it's anywhere from $25 to $50 round trip, depending on where you're going. We use an amazing tour company called Nacho Tours. All we do is we let them know ahead of time. They arrive at the airport. They have our name. You know, there we have private transportation. It's ready to go. And then we use them for everything, even if we're going downtown or into the city. And it's just great because we feel safe and we know that we're getting, not only be taken care of, but we're getting a really good deal. So I'm going to put their number below. We don't get anything for endorsing them at all. It's just that we really feel safe and we feel good using this company. All right, so tip number five is booking excursions. And once again, the theme is still there. Plan ahead and do your research because there's a lot to choose from. And it's very easy to be taken advantage of if you're not doing your research. In fact, it happened to me. I can't even believe it because I'm always one to do research. We were at a resort and they were wanting us to swim, do an excursion of swimming with the dolphins. And I thought, I looked at the pictures, the dolphins are in the ocean, and you know, you're with your kids and you think dolphins are so cute, this would be fun. So we booked it, and my kids, I kept telling them, we're gonna go on a boat, it's gonna be so fun, you know, kept, you know, talking about being on this boat all day. And so when we get there, it's just this big pool, like a big swimming pool, and the dolphins are in it. And it was really disappointing, to be honest. But I was more disappointed myself for not doing the research and knowing better. And it was not cheap. You know, these excursions can cost anywhere from $100 to $200 per person, and it can add up very quickly. So you want to make sure that you're doing your research, know what it includes, know exactly what you're getting yourself into, where you're going, and everything. And then when you get to the excursions, you have to be careful because they continue to try to take advantage of you. They wanted us to buy like $100 pictures and take us through the gift shop. And, you know, so it doesn't end just with the excursion. So just make sure that you have done all your research, you know what you're getting into. And I'm not saying don't do them. Just make sure you are really knowing everything about it before you book it. All right, so tip number 6 is those annoying sales pitches and timeshare calls. Okay, so the first thing is you have to be assertive. All right, right up front, let them know you're not interested. If they become so annoying, you could get the manager involved. Now, the other thing they use is the resort credits. So be careful of those resort credits because they use those to get you to book excursions. Don't think they're not making money off of it. They are. And then further, they will call your room in the morning and tell you, oh, you have $500, you know, dollars in resort credits that you would like to use. Let me tell you about the excursions today. And it goes on and on and on. So we found a super secret tip. Shh, don't tell anyone. Unplug the phone. Unplug the phone because then they can't call you and annoy you. They may, you know, see you down in the lobby and say, oh, you still have those resort credits to use, which is fine, but at least they won't be waking you up. So our biggest tip is just be assertive and don't fall for it. So tip number 7 is those Cancun beaches. And I know there's a lot of talk about the beaches full of seaweed and they're not in great condition. So if you're a pool person, you're good to go. Most of the resorts have amazing pools, but if you really, really want that beach vacation, you can have it in Cancun. There are some resorts that have amazing beaches. There were a few that we went to that were not that great, but then there were a few that were wonderful. In fact, downtown Playa del Carmen, the beaches were amazing. So again, it goes back to just do your research, you know, go on YouTube, whatever you need to do. But if you really want that beach vacation, you can have it in Cancun. All right, so our final tip, which is tip number 8, is going downtown, the nightlife in Cancun. And I know they're always telling you, stay at the resort. They're scaring you. They're saying it's not safe. But we've actually been to both downtown Cancun and downtown Playa del Carmen, and we had an amazing and safe experience. We never felt one time that we were not safe. In fact, we felt safer in these two cities than we do sometimes in our own cities here in the U.S. Our biggest tip for that, though, is look for packages. You know, don't fall into the Coco Bongo necessarily. I know everyone wants to do that. If you want to do that, that's great. You know, look into packages though, because we were able to get for $69 transportation into the nightclub, all inclusive drinks and transportation back. And we danced the night away. It was amazing. It was so much fun. So please don't let the media scare you, you know, of not experiencing this, you know, in Cancun or Playa del Carmen, because really, really, that was one of the highlights of our whole trip. So our final tip is to follow us at 3 Days and Tres Noches. We're going to give you amazing travel tips, reviews, and videos, and show you that you can have amazing, fun vacations in just 3 days and 3 nights. Please subscribe to our channel and like this video.